What's my favorite modular app feature? What a great question. Thank you for asking. Well, for me, it's built-in functions. Built-in functions are functions that require no extra logic, just plug and play. They capture Slack native functionality such as sending DMs, creating channels, creating user groups, you name it. In this video, we'll go over how to use built-in functions in modular apps, and maybe, just maybe, they'll become your favorite feature too. This video discusses the concepts of functions and workflows. So if you haven't watched those videos yet, please do that first and then come back to this one. Currently, we offer around 12 built-in functions that you can try out. You'll notice that each function has a specific schema ID, scopes, inputs, and outputs. Let's see how we can apply this to an app. If you haven't already, make sure you've installed the Slack CLI. For this video, we'll be referencing the Welcome Bot sample app. We'll make sure to link the repo for that app in the description. Clone Welcome Bot by running the Slack CLI command shared in the README. Under the Workflows directory, open the createWelcomeMessage.ts file. Built-in functions are added as steps to a workflow, so you will likely define them in the same file. Let's take a closer look. The Welcome Bot uses two built-in functions, open form and send ephemeral message. Open form has some special features, so we'll cover that built-in function in a separate video. When working with built-in functions, you'll need to make sure you're importing the schema object from the Duino SDK. Let's look at the send ephemeral message built-in function. WelcomeBot uses this function to send a confirmation message to the user who has filled out the form, letting them know the welcome message has been successfully created. To call a built-in function, you need to use the addStep method and add the built-in function as a step to your workflow. Here, we're adding the send ephemeral message built-in function as a step to the message setup workflow. The function requires a channel ID, user ID, and message inputs. In this case, we're getting the value for the channel ID from the output in the previous step. The user ID comes from the interactivity object in the workflow definition, and the message value has been hard-coded in. But what if we would prefer this message to appear as a public message that everyone in the channel can see? Instead of writing a custom function and making a separate call to chat.postMessage, let's try to use another built-in function. We're going to change the send ephemeral message function into a send message function. The send message function only has two required inputs. We'll keep the channel ID the same, remove the user ID, and make some tweaks to the message. Now, when we run the app again, we can see that the return message is in fact a public one. So this was a success. As you can see, built-in functions are a true time saver. That's it for today's video. Thank you for watching. I hope I've convinced you about the greatness of built-in functions. And if you want to learn more about modular apps, please watch our other videos. And also, please, please provide us with your thoughts, your comments, your feedback in the comments below, or send us a tweet over here. And until next time, bye.